Yeah, no, it was extraordinary. I mean, I thought it'd be terribly boring, like most conference speeches, but it was just fabulous. And I know a lot of people who are probably nicer than me felt very sorry for her. But I thought it was very, very funny.
It's a bad sign when a cough suite goes down better than you do.
She coughed so much, it felt like she was going to start coughing insects. Like an actual horror film.
But it's that moment when you're talking to someone who doesn't really believe what they're saying, and they're saying, yes, I'm really the person for the job. And everything's going very...
Coughing does not do well for female politicians. Her and Hillary Clinton, yeah. Their colds have destroyed them.
Well, Ian Duncan Smith used to cough a lot. Mm. Do you remember? He was another successful Tory leader.
He never had it that bad, though.
No, you don't think so?
No, it's a sort of much lower level cough-based problem. Theresa May took it to... I mean, she weaponised. That was quite incredible. I can't believe you didn't feel any sympathy for her at all. Not even a scintilla.
Oh, dear.
I did.
I think I'm coming across as a bad person.
Awful. I only felt sorry for her because of Boris. I feel that she's... That was such a bad day that it was almost a win for Boris, and I feel that's the only... So I feel like I hate him so much that you want her to have a better gig, you know? Why don't she sack Boris?
She can't. She can't, can she, sack Boris?
Why?
Because if she sacks him, he gets to walk away from Brexit while simultaneously being able to claim that if he'd stayed in the government, it all would have gone much better than it's clearly going to go.
You know, she can't allow him the pleasure. It's like, you know, he's essentially an arsonist who wants to come back dressed as a fireman.
Yes. Yes.
Where's the fire?
There was one of her... So, I mean, she's been accused of being robotic, so one of the Conservative backbenchers today was making the rounds in the TV studio saying she's made of very strong metal, which I thought was...
Well, people say that at a certain point the Prime Minister runs out of luck. Mm. It just happens to you when everything's going wrong.
Yeah. It's like the end. It's like the complete end. She's not so much as occupying the office of Prime Minister, it's haunting it.
I mean, again, it's difficult to make up, but the first letter is F, so it's an F off.
An F off. 15% of respondents to a YouGov poll said that the speech had gone well. 15, which is, there's no way that could just be the cabinet. 15% of people. 15% of people watched that and thought, yes, that's gone rather well. Which makes you wonder what it would take to lower that number from 15%. She could have stood there and melted like the witch at the end of The Wizard of Oz. 12% think it went rather well. She's a puddle on the floor. 10% still think it's gone rather well. It's 15%.
Are you sure that isn't just members of the Labour Party? Former Prime Minister.
That's the 1922 committee. Yeah.
That's the Queen. No, that's Andrea Leadsom. Oh, God.
At time of recording, who's Prime Minister?
Boris Johnson.
It is currently Theresa May.
Oh, right, of course.
Yeah, but how bad have things got for Theresa May?
There's been another cabinet revolt. She won't even see her main ministers. She's now got a cabinet of two, herself and her husband. even he's walking out. Everyone's gone. Andrea Leadsom's gone, you saw there.
Do you know what number Andrea Leadsom is on the resignation list under Theresa May? How many have gone?
36.
She's the 36th minister. There's a graph from the BBC.
A graph on a comedy show. This is the third.
This is a graph of ministerial resignations before Theresa May, and here it is with Theresa May on it.
This is Theresa May's plan to end the Brexit deadlock. According to the Sunday Times, Philip May's emphasis has shifted to hoping his wife can escape from number 10 with dignity. Sorry, Phil, but however she finally goes, Colonel Gaddafi left with more dignity.
Quite right.
Brexit has clearly put a strain on Theresa May's marriage, but there's no way they'll split up, as Philip May knows negotiating a divorce deal would take years, and he'd need the support of Jeremy Corbyn. According to the Telegraph, MPs are sitting in the longest parliamentary session since the English Civil War. Or, as future historians will call it, English Civil War I.
The director.
Paisley pyjamas. Rather indeed. Small pattern. That's a middle-aged man. Mm-hmm. He's just enlarging it. Oh, dear. That's one of your lot.
Did you remember him?
Yes, he was Minister for Civil Society. And he was being very polite in his way.
This story is about a sting, isn't it? This is about a national newspaper, shall we call them the Mirror for the sake of argument, setting up a bloke look like a woman and really just sort of enticing a Conservative MP to do something that some people might say was unusual.
Yeah. Would you say it was unusual?
Well, I think it's... I have to say, in all fairness, to wear paisley pyjamas is completely unusual.
How did the Mirror justify the publication of this story?
They said it was really funny.
In fact, they said Brooks knew Mark was a legitimate target as he was the Minister for Civil Society and the founder of Women to Win, a campaign to get more females into politics.
It would only be hypocrisy if he was the Minister for Genital Concealment. I think there is a public interest.
The Sunday Mirror's editor vigorously defended the paper's actions, saying subterfuge was used in this investigation and we have been very clear about that from the start. So, presumably, the correspondence began, "Hello, I'm a male tabloid journalist, posing as a 21-year-old blonde woman. Would you mind sending me a photo of your penis, please?"
The director of the Paris Archdiocese, Philippe de Couverville, told The Times, "We tend to wait for things to become catastrophic before we take care of them." To which Theresa May replied, "Oh, you too."
If you really want to know what the members of the Cabinet are thinking, you have to watch Newsnight.
Yes.
And listen to Nicholas Watt.
I said to one Cabinet Minister, why is the Prime Minister holding a vote when she's pretty sure that she's going to lose? And using very strong language, this Cabinet Minister said to me, "Fuck knows, I'm past caring, it's like the living dead in here." Oh.
Following a tense meeting of the 1922 committee, evidence emerges as to who ate Sir Graham Brady's donut. Rees-Mogg was obviously very appalled by all this, but he does have his Facebook supporters group boost his morale. Have you seen his Facebook?
No, well, it's actually been outlawed because it's based in Broadmoor.
Let's have a look at this illuminating forum. Just for interest's sake, are there any young folk on this site? Yes, I'm 55.
What has Boris done for the second time in 6 months?
Nothing.
Gone home in the same direction?
Finally, 72-year-old becomes the oldest competitor in what?
Young Conservatives leadership.
So this is the news that scientists have released the first ever picture of a black hole.
Theresa May is very excited about this because it's a whole new entity out there with which we might do a trade deal in due course. And she's just glad there's another despairing vortex sucking in all human life and light from which there is no escape.
The next episode of the demise of Theresa May, who's gone from being the Iron Lady to a sort of flatter version, like the Ironed Lady, instead.
So nothing is happening. There was a big coup. We thought we were going to get, you know, a new Prime Minister, but no.
It's a bit like a very dull, slow Attenborough, isn't it? Where the same wounded wildebeest just keeps limping across the plain and the hyenas can't quite get organised enough to kill her off. Basically, what it is now.
Yes, it's about the week of plotting and infighting in the Tory party. Mm. There was speculation this week that Theresa might demote Boris Johnson in a reshuffle. Why might that not work?
He said he won't be demoted.
That's absolutely right. According to The Telegraph, allies of Boris warned that if May tried to demote him, he would just say no. We learnt more about the principal stance Boris Johnson took when he decided to back Brexit last year. What was that?
Well, he confessed to someone that he changed his mind and became a Leaver just to annoy Cameron.
Yeah.
Sorry. He confessed it in an interview.
Yes, yes, well, according to the Mail, so... Do you call that an interview?
Can we edit that bit out so people believe it?
Yeah. Well, according to a reputable paper...
Can we edit that bit out as well?
It was to Lord Adonis.
Lord Adonis.
Can you imagine being called Lord Adonis?
Hey.
It's quite a lot to live up to in the morning.
Lord Adonis. Yeah. That's my safe word. I'm only joking. You're never safe with me.
So as the good ship Theresa sinks slowly beneath the waves, who are the latest Tories to thrust themselves forward?
Oh, I don't like that expression. I don't think anybody in the Tory party can thrust. I don't think they've got their own hips. I think everyone who's been elected ever as a Tory thinks I could do a better job than Theresa May. I mean, they're not wrong.
I think you have to have a photo shoot in your kitchen to get into the race.
Yes. This is James Brokenshire. Here he is, with his Meg.
Oh, that is a lovely
That's
kitchen.
Him. I know. And he's Count got... the ovens, Tom. Count the ovens.
Four... Four ovens?
That we know of. There could be more.
There could be more that come...
It was George Eustace who quit as farming minister in February. So let's see a colleague in the Scottish Parliament's alarmingly frank assessment of him.
I personally have met with Andrea Leadison and I've had two meetings with George Eustace.
Evidence emerges to show why agreeing even the most basic of trade deals has taken Liam Fox such a long time.
There's Gavin Williamson walking, which is something he's not denying.
And that's a brilliant bit of dramatised leaking.
Yeah. Oh, Helen Mirren's stuck for work. She's... Gavin Williamson has been fired for allegedly leaking secrets, but he swears on his children's life that it wasn't him. And he has been fired by Theresa May, which is unusual because she loves not firing people. Mm. She's a big fan of just letting people stay, Chris Grayling.
Normally, you know, if you sacked your defence secretary, it would be three volumes of a history book. But with this government, yeah, all right, he's gone.
Theresa May seems so definite that he did it that I'm assuming he didn't.
This is the news that Gavin Williamson has been sacked as Secretary of State for Defense over the Huawei leak. As The Guardian put it, Williamson is the first cabinet minister to go for a leak since 1986. How has Williamson responded?
He accused her of ingratitude. He said, I've saved your career twice, as though anyone's going to be grateful for that.
Yeah, that does mean prison, I think. he admits to that.
I think maybe he did it, he just didn't realise. Because he seems very adamant that he did not do it. Yeah. If you're going to swear on your children's life, that's...
Yeah, I don't think we should hold him to that.
But he said it, Andy. Oh. He said it.
Well, it's fine, though. He doesn't have any kids. There you go.
Not anymore.
Or he won't.
Johnny, yeah. You were in the army.
Yeah.
You sit on that committee. Is this a good idea?
No, I mean, it doesn't sound great, but the people who know this stuff seem to think it's all right, but, you know...
You don't sound totally lukewarm, even.
my political vim and vigour is on its last legs, I think. Much like the government.
The rest of the
Has anything happened?
Well, she's been to Brussels, and everything
that
has
happens
changed.
Every week.
People say, oh, we missed Brexit Day, March the 29th. It's not happened. But if you listen to what they're saying in Brussels, they're saying, well, actually, we might give you another extension and we can still have a Brexit Day. And there are some people there who think, well, let's have it every year, every single March the 29th. Theresa May or somebody like her will trot off to Brussels and say, we'll have another 12-month extension.
Yeah.
And Brexit will still definitely be happening, but we'll just sort of...
Yeah, you know. And we could tell everyone we've left... And then just not mention it again.
Exactly. But Halloween, you know, is the next cut-off.
Do you think that was a joke by the Europeans?
I think it was a joke. But you've got Tory MPs going around saying, oh, well, we must dress up as something for Halloween, you know.
How about as MPs?
Well... Theresa Mayhem in a £900 coat. There she is, flying off to Brussels to be told what to do and say and think. The real Prime Minister.
On the left.
The traitor's kiss. The Politburo, or is that Bexley Heath Council? and a man on a bike.
What are the rival camps calling Jeremy Hunt?
Sounds like.
I got it. Apparently, Jeremy Hunt is called Theresa in Trousers. or TIT for short. Did you see how Liz Truss dealt with the question on LBC?
No, but I can't wait.
What do you think of having another EU referendum?
A very, very, very bad idea.
But people can change their minds, can't they?
But they were told in the referendum in 2016 that their vote would be implemented, and the reality is the vote needs to be implemented.
But what about the people who've changed their minds between then and now?
I don't think people have changed their minds. Everyone I speak to... I have, that's true.
Who are you backing in the Conservative leadership election?
There isn't one. There isn't a Conservative leadership
election. Should there be one in the near future, if that's something we can
I don't know if that's going to happen.
What are they doing running around trying to get each other's votes, then?
You're not going to believe this, but some of my colleagues are slightly more fixated with their own careers than what's going on in Brexit.
I know. Now, that is shocking.
Right. absolute shock. So, yeah, some people are running around trying to be Prime Minister at a time of national crisis.
Including Mrs. May.
Theresa May still have support among the grassroots outside the Westminster bubble. How did she get on in Wales this week?
She got heckled.
Yes, she did, didn't she?
Yep, she made a speech to local party activists and everything went well for the first 5 seconds. Then...
Thank you. Thank you, everybody, and...
Why don't you resign?
Hondar.
Well, she did a bit of Welsh there. I mean, she knows how to say what a knobhead in Welsh, so that's handy.